We have before us the post-mortem report of the deceased Sadhana, which confirms that the deceased had died at about 23 hours on 13 December 2001 due to asphyxia as a result of anti-mortem injuries found on the dead body of the deceased. Dr. A.S. Rathaur, who had conducted the post-mortem of the dead body of the deceased and prepared and proved her post-mortem report during the trial, disposed that the anti-mortem injury number 2 found on the deceased or dead body fully corroborates the manner of assault on the deceased Sadhana as described in the FIR. Before we embark upon to examine on merits of the rival contentions raised by the learned counsel for the parties before us, we find it appropriate to evaluate the evidence on record regarding the actual occurrence and it being witnessed by the so-called eyewitnesses. Although PW1 in her examination in chief has fully corroborated the version of the incident as narrated by her in the written complaint, Excal, and proved the same, but she on page 9 and 10 of the paper book in her cross-examination deposed that the father of Pawan Kumar was also living with him and her daughter in his house, and when on the date of incident, accused appellant had come to his house in a drunken state and started abusing his daughter, and her daughter had related the accused appellant had created an ugly sense in his house on which her daughter had complained to her father-in-law that she was being beaten up by her husband. She further deposed that no one from the locality was present in the house at the time of occurrence, and the accused appellant had severely beaten his father, also causing multiple injuries to him, but his father had kept quiet and had not made any noise, and after beating his father, the accused appellant had left the house and gone somewhere, and it was then that she had father of the accused appellant had gone to the police station, where she was informed that the police would soon reach the place of occurrence. However, when she returned from the police station to the house of her daughter Sadhana, after a lapse of considerable time, she saw her daughter lying dead in the vardana of her house. In the meantime, the police had also arrived. Thus, from the facts deposed by PW1 in her cross-examination, it is proved that although on the date of the occurrence, an application had taken place between the accused appellant, his wife Sadhana, and his father, and he had beaten both his wife and his father in a drunken state, and thereafter he had left his house and gone somewhere. It also follows from her evidence that when she and father of the accused appellant had gone to the police station, leaving the deceased Sadhana in the house, she was alive, and after they had returned from the police station, after a lapse of considerable time, they had found the dead body of the deceased Sadhana lying in the verandah of the house of accused appellant. In view of the above, the claim of PW1 that she was present at the place of incident at the time of the actual assault, and she had seen that the accused appellant pressing her neck with a shawl, which resulted in her death, does not appear to be true. It transpires from the evidence that no one was present in the house of the accused appellant at the time when her daughter was to death. It is noteworthy that PW1 was neither declared hostile after having failed to support the prosecution case, nor she was confronted by the DGC with the facts deposed by her in her examination in chief by re-examining her. Since from the evidence of PW1 itself, it is proved that at the time when the accused appellant Pawan Kumar had left his house after quarreling with his wife and father, his wife Sadhana was alive, and the prosecution having failed to lead any evidence to prove that after PW1 had left for the police station with the father-in-law of her daughter Sadhana, who was admittedly alive at that time, the accused appellant had returned back to his house, it cannot be said that what had happened inside the house.